Hi, and welcome to our talk, Dorabella Cipher is Musical Inspiration. This is presented by Abram Hindel. The work is written and coded by Bradley Hauer, Colin Choi, Abram Hindel, Scott Smallwood, and Greg Kondrak. We're all from the University of Alberta. The Dorabella Cipher was a cipher written on a postcard from the composer Edward Elgar to Dora Penny in 1897. Edward Elgar was interesting because he was a famous composer who composed Pomp and Circumstance, but he also had an interest in cryptography, and he composed the Enigma Variations as well, which was a cryptographic-based composition. The cipher that he sent to Dora Penny in 1897 composed of 87 symbols and 3 lines. Each character is basically 1 to 3 bumps rotated in 8 different directions. Prior work has tried to decipher the Dorabella cipher as natural language text, and the focus of decipherment has typically been in a natural language setting. For instance, Sams in 1970 came up with a decipherment. Larks, it's chaotic, but a cloak obscures my new letters, A, B, I own the dark, makes E, E, sigh, when you are gone too long. How would we recognize this as a solution? We'd probably have to use some kind of model that would say whether or not a solution was legitimate. Sams probably did this by hand and was using his own brain to suggest that's a plausible solution. There are many natural language decipherments of Dorabella, and none of them are truly accepted. So we thought, hey, let's try to decipher it as music. So the goal is not necessarily to get the true decipherment, but rather, can we use the mechanism of decipherment to help us compose new music? So we're going to use a monoalphabetic substitution cipher for this because it's mostly easy to use and easy to understand. Essentially, your key is what a symbol is transposed into. So given the characters A to Z, we might have a key of random characters O to V. So if you look on the side here, we've got ourselves a plain text that we want to encrypt, advise the mayor. We've got a key that maps letters like A to O, and D to P, and V to Y, and then that allows us to convert it into this unreadable text. This is a monoalphabetic substitution cipher. One symbol, one character, okay? In our case, instead of a character, we're going to replace one symbol with one note. So it'll be a note on the keyboard. To tell if we've actually found the right decipherment or a legitimate decipherment or a plausible decipherment, we'll use the n-gram language models from natural language text processing, and we will use them basically to predict the next token given the previous n-1 tokens. That's kind of how the n-grams work. And based on this, we can actually compare the predictions versus what we had. And we can come up with probabilities based on the corpus, probabilities that we can represent as probability, as perplexity, as cross-entropy. These probabilities allow us to estimate whether or not a sequence of tokens were probably omitted from our corpus. Were they surprising to the corpus? Did they not occur in the corpus, or are they common? Using this idea of n-gram language models to tell you if what you've deciphered is correct, Norvig in 2009 suggested a simple method. Essentially, generate a key, so just randomly shuffle letters around, and then consider all the transpositions of that key, all the swaps, and then take the best swap, right? The best swap, and use that as a new key, right? So each time you do a swap, you evaluate it. You basically get the probability of it occurring from the model. The one that has the highest probability coming from the model, you keep that, and then you swap on that until you don't increase in probability anymore. But we're going to do this in music, so we actually have to not only deal with symbols, we have to deal with notes. And 24 symbols are not enough to encode very much detailed information about music. The MIDI spec has 127 different notes, from C0 to like, to probably it's 8 or 10. So it's many octaves. If Dorabella is music, we basically want to use a simple encoding. It's unlikely that, that Elgar was really hopping a ton of octaves in this case if he encoded it in a simple pitch-based manner. So we're going to focus on pitch. We're going to ignore duration. So we assume every note takes the same amount of time. We're going to ignore dynamics. We're not going to have rests. We're going to ignore non-note symbols. Furthermore, because we only have 24 symbols, we're going to choose 24 notes from the range A3 to E6 based upon the most common notes that are in our corpus, right? And the corpus that we're going to be asking a language model about is parts of the cantus corpus of folk music melodies. These ones are all standardized in the key of C. They have a 4-4 meter. They have multiple melodies. There's about 1,500 in total. Some are very short. Some are quite long. They're all shorter than the Dorabella, but some have very short sequences, which could be part of the Dorabella itself, the Dorabella cipher. So first off, let's see if this actually works. So what we're going to do is we're going to take 300 melody samples. We're going to encrypt them using a monoalphabetic substitution cipher, and then we are going to decrypt them, and we're going to calculate average decipherment accuracy, basically the number of notes deciphered correctly, and we got about 55%. So given an encrypted sequence, we can decode every character to about 55%. So we can reasonably expect decipherment by this method to be mostly correct. Okay, is it good enough? It won't necessarily solve the Dorabella cipher, but then again, our goal is not to actually solve the cipher, it's to get music out of the cipher such that we can produce a composition with it. So how are we going to treat the cipher as symbols? We still have to encode the Dorabella cipher. Well, you remember that we talked about bumps. They had 1 to 3 bumps, and they're angled in 8 different ways. So what we've got here is a way of encoding each direction, and then with the number of bumps or semicircles. We transcribed it multiple times, so multiple people transcribed it, and then we used majority vote on our transcriptions to figure out which one we should keep, because there was some disagreement about the angle and the number of bumps. We produced a raw decipherment, and that's this one right here. And it's a little random. It's not super musical. Our composer, Scott Smallwood, thought it was pretty random, but he saw some musicality in there, and he thought that he could take a swing at it from a composition angle. And he produced a new version where he altered the notes, and you can see that the red notes are the changed notes here. They've been altered or added, and he added chords, essentially using the original deciphered Dorabella and then using that as inspiration for an actual composition. We'll play that in the video. In conclusion, we do not claim that we have solved the Dorabella cipher. We merely tried to solve it as music using statistical models that natural language processing uses that are corpus-based. We've provided empirical validation of music decipherment, and we've also discussed a novel and creative method of composing melodies and ultimately producing a listenable melody from the Dorabella cipher itself. All right, thank you for your attention. We'll play what Scott composed for you.